Today we are going to see the experiment on the veins itself. It's an impact of jets on the veins. So veins are naturally used in turbines itself. Those are the blades over there, and there are different types of vein. One is an with respect to shape, maybe with respect to an angle it might be. So today we are going to see the efficiency of the veins with respect to three types. One is an flat, one is an inclined, which is a 15 degree in angle, one is a hemispherical vein. Okay, and the jet here, the dimensions of that jet is around 15 mm and 20 mm, and the collection tank, which has got 0.25 meter square in the capacity itself. Okay, so now what we are going to do here, so these are the observation and tabular column itself. So type of vein, that is an flat, inclined and hemispherical itself. So next observation we should take is time rise, the time taken to rise 10 cm of water in that actual tank itself, collection tank, with respect to t seconds. So number of times you can do here is maximum 3. The actual force, so the force measuring device which has been set up to that instrument, you need to measure that force in terms of kg. Okay, so this is the observation and tabular column to the experiment itself. So these are the formulas which should be required to use and calculate. You need to calculate an actual discharge Q equal to AC into 10 divided by 100 into T. So T you need to do that in the experiment table itself. Okay, so AC has been already given. So V equals to, so velocity equals to V equals to Q by A itself in terms of meter per second, and you need to calculate the theoretical force exerted on the beam itself. So this part you need to calculate on all the three veins. Okay, so first, when you consider a flat vein, the theoretical force exerted equals to rho a v square. So rho is nothing but density of water, and it is given in terms of total kg per meter cube itself. Now we have got an inclined vein, so inclined plate, it is the formula is given as rho a v square into sin theta over here. So theta here, there is a 15 degree of that. So hemispherical vein, we have got in theoretical force, that equals to 2 rho a v square. Here theta equals to 0 over here. Calculated the previously theoretical, now actual force you need to calculate over here, actual force exerted on that vein itself. So actual force equals to F into 9.81, this F is being taken in that instrument itself, force measuring instrument. Then we need to find the efficiency for each vein. So efficiency nu equals to what? Force actual divided by force theoretical into 100. So that will be determined in terms of percentage. So next part, what we are going to do is we're going to laboratory and we are going to conduct the test on the veins itself. So thank you. Hi everyone. This is Professor Satish Kuli. Today we are going to conduct experiment on impact of jet. Okay, or you can say jet on veins. Okay, so here this is an experiment which is a part of fluid mechanics lab for the fourth semester as per the VTU curriculum itself. So this experiment is very much important to study the efficiency of veins over here. Why we need to understand the efficiency of vein? Because the veins are fitted in the turbine. So based on what type of veins are present in that turbine, we can determine the efficiency of that turbine also. So here what we are going to do is we have gotten three types of veins. So first one is a flat vein which is already fitted in this apertus. Next, we have got an inclined vein over here. We have got an hemispherical vein. We have got two types of nozzles. One is of N 15 mm in dia, one is of 20 mm in dia. So this is a 20 mm dia. The 15 mm diameter nozzle is already fitted in this apertus itself. Now, we should take in this apertus, we are going to take reading at the two points. One is at the energy point, okay, the force point, so how much is the force exerted, that we are going to take the reading. One is at the level of collection time, so we are going to take the reading on the piezometer itself. Okay, so before we start up experiment, one point we should remember, that key we should do the priming in the centrifugal pump. Another one thing is, this energy meter should read 0. Okay, so how it can be read 0? By adjusting this contour weight inwards or in outwards itself. Okay, so we are making that to the 0. So here it is reading now to the 0 itself. Okay, So as we have given in the manual itself, we have got in tabular column, in that we have got diameter. So I can show you here, we have got in diameter, we have got the number of trials, we have got time taken to raise 10 cm water level. So that is in the collection tank itself. We have got an actual force reading. So actual force reading F can be read over here itself. Okay. So I am going to start taking the reading and conducting this experiment. So what I am going to do now here is I am going to start the motor here. So now when I start the motor, so the jet is hitting that flat plane over there. Okay, so when it is hitting, this 4 meter is reading that reading. So how much it is reading? Around 500. So you can see the reading is around 500. Okay, so what I am going to do here is, in that I am going to write it 0.50. Okay, so now that is being written in actual force reading, that is F. Okay, now go to the next point. Next point is I am taking with respect to 10 cm height, that is mentioned already in the manual itself. How much time it is taking to fill up that tank itself. Okay, so now I am going to close the wall. I am going to put an imaginary point that is in 7 cm over here. I am going to start the stop clock with 7 cm. Then with respect to the 17 cm, how much time it is taking to fill up, that I am going to see over here. Okay, so now I am going to wait till the piezometer readings reach 17. So when it reached 17, I am going to stop the clock. So the stop clock reading is around 30.7. So that reading I am going to enter over here itself. So that is 30.7. Now this is the first set of reading. So for the second set of reading, what I am going to do is I am going to vary the flow over here. So when I raise the flow over here, you can see that energy reading is also being changed, or the force reading has been changed. So now the force reading is reading around 350. So 350 again right here as an 0.35, because this is gauge is given in terms of kg. So each distance are of 10. Okay. So that in that sense it is 0.35. So now, what I am going to do over here is, now we are going to take a piezometer reading over here. Now again with respect to a 10 cm height, so what I am going to do is I am going to close the discharge wall over here. I am going to select an imaginary point. So now I am going to select 6. So 6 plus 10 is 16. Sorry, it has been crossed already 6. So what I am going to do over here is I am going to take 10 over here. Okay, so 10 plus 10 is 20. So now I am going to start a clock, stop clock around 10 over here when the piezometer reads 10. Okay, so now piezometer reading also I have started a stop clock. So now I am going to see how much time it will take to reach 20. So I am waiting till that piezometer reading reaches 20, and I am going to note down what the time taken to reach that point 20. How much time it has been taken. I'm going to wait. Okay. Still it reaches 20. Okay, it has reached now 20. So the time here is around 37.85. So I'm going to write there like 37.85. Now for the third set of reading, what I am going to do is, I am going to vary the flow again. Okay. And continue that same process for that flat line. Okay. Now, we have seen the calculation, we have seen how to take the reading with respect to a flat line. Now what I am going to do is, I am going to fit an inclined vane. So how I'm going to fix all that is, simply open this door, remove that flat vane, okay. So now I'm going to fix the inclined vane over here. I'm going to fix the inclined vane. So when you fix an inclined vane, again what happens there is, due to weight of that, okay, the readings again tend to change over here, that energy force reading itself. So I need to again adjust this counterbalance weight to make sure that it reads zero. Okay, now what I'm going to do is the same process which we have done for a flat vane itself. So I'm going to start the motor again, and now you can see that the jet is hitting that inclined vane over here. So I'm going to read the reading. So I'm going to read the reading itself. So now reading here is around say 1, okay. So that I'm going to enter here itself. Now what I'm going to do? Again I'm going to see here, okay, with respect to 10 cm height in the piezometer, how much time it is being taken, the water that is being collected in a collection tank over here. So now I'm going to close this discharge door. Okay. Again, I'm going to fix an imaginary point over here. So now I'm going to take a 6 over here. When it reaches the 6, I'm going to start the stop clock. I have started the stop clock over here. I'm going to see till 16 centimeter height how much time it is taken. Okay. And I'm going to note that time over here itself. So I'm going to wait till that reaches that 10 centimeter height. I'm going to wait till that reaches a 10 centimeter height. Okay, so the reading is 53.27. So I'm going to enter that reading. So 0.1 and 53.25. So that I'm going to enter over here. Okay, so this is the first set of reading. Now for the second set of reading, what I'm going to do here is, I'm going to again vary the flow. Again, you can see that the energy reading has been changed. It is now showing 200.3, so that is nothing but 0.23. So that I am going to enter over here. Now, what I am going to do here is I'm going to close the discharge wall over here. I'm going to wait, the piezometer reading just rises. I'm going to fix an imaginary point. In this point, I'm going to take a 7. I'm going to start the stop clock when it has reached the 7. I already started it because it has reached the 7. So I'm going to take how much time it is taking to reach the 17 point over here. So now I'm going to wait till it reaches that 17 mark over there itself. Okay. I'm just waiting till it reaches that point. Okay. It has reached that point. I'm going to stop my stop clock. It is reading 39 seconds, 88 milliseconds. So that I am going to enter over here.
So that is 39.88.
Okay. So again, what I am going to do is I am going to vary the flow for the first set of readings and continue the same process 8 times. Okay. The process will be continued as same as for the third set of experiment also. Now what we are going to do is I am going to change the vein over here. Instead of flat, I am going to put an inclined vein over here. I'm going to put an hemispherical vein over here instead of an inclined vein. I'm going to put an hemispherical vein over here. So again, what you need to do is again you need to adjust this counterbalance weight to make sure that the force reading becomes zero. So again, I have adjusted and made that force reading become zero. And again, I'm going to start the motor. And I started the motor. I'm going to read the reading, okay, the force reading as well as the piezometer reading, and the process remains the same as it was in inclined and in the flat plane itself. So thank you very much. This was the experiment regarding jet on vane itself. Okay, so in the next video, what we are going to do is I'm going to show you how to do the calculations on this experiment itself. So thank you very much. Hi everyone, today we are seeing the experiment on impact of jet on vanes. Okay, so what we are doing here is you are going to find efficiency. So efficiency is given by F actual divided by F theoretical. Okay, for the different set of vanes. So first one is in flat vane, second one is an inclined vane. Inclined vein, and third one is an hemispherical vein. So these are the veins all we have in our laboratory itself. So today I'm going to take the calculation regarding flat vein, and similarly you can do it for inclined and hemispherical vein. Only the theoretical formula here tend to get changed over here. Okay, so you need to find, as I said, an efficiency, that is F actual divided by F theoretical. Okay, so we have a formula with respect to F actual, like F into 9.81. this F is nothing but where we have measured the force in force measuring device in the equipment itself, and F theoretical with the flat vane is rho A into V square. So we need to find V over here. Okay, so first thing what we are going to do is we need to find Q. So Q equals to what? Q equals to AC into 10 divided by T into 100. So AC is 0.25, that has been given in manual itself. Okay, it's the length and breadth of the tank. 10 divided by the time taken T here is 23 as per the first set of calculation into 100. So this value will be around 0.00108 meter cube per second. Next, what we are doing is we are finding the value of V. So V is how much? V is 0.00108 divided by pi by 4 into 0.015. okay, so this value is nothing but it is the diameter of nozzle. It is around 15 mm. Okay, dia of jet. Okay, this value is around 6.136 meter per second. Okay, so now by using these values, what we are going to do is we are going to find F theoretical. So that is rho A V square. So rho here is 1000 into pi by 4 into 0.015 square into 6.136 square. That is velocity. So we have gotten value here around 6.653 Newton. So next, what we are going to do is we are going to find F actual. So F actual equals to what? F into 9.81. So here we have got 0.89. This F that is being taken in the conduction of experiment. Okay, so this is 9.81. So you got the value around 7.848 Newton. So now you're going to find the efficiency, that is F actual by F theoretical. Okay, by substituting the values, you will have the efficiency. So in this way, you need to calculate the efficiency for inclined as well as efficiency for hemispherical vane itself. Okay, so this and the calculations of impact of jet on the vanes. Thank you. Previously you have seen so the calculation part as well as the conduction itself, and now see here what we can do here itself key. we have conducted 1-2 trials with this data sheet regarding is about the journal itself. So we have done here flat vane, hemispherical as well as inclined. So number of trials 1 and 2. So in collection tank to raise the 10 centimeter water level, it has taken here 23 seconds, here 22 seconds. I'm talking only with respect to flat vane here. Now they have done the calculation regarding taking this data sheet itself. So actual force reading, so which we have rated there itself while conduction. So here it is around 800 grams itself. We have written wrongly. So 650 grams itself. So now they have done the calculation with theoretical. They have found out. They have found out Q actual, and similarly they have found out the efficiency also. So here you can see with the second trial also they have done it. So they have found out the actual theoretical force and actual force. Okay, they have found out the efficiency again with hemispherical vane also. So okay, and this is the last data sheet what they have entered over here. So in this way you need to enter the data sheet in your journals also. So thank you very much. Stay tuned for my further videos also.